Good morning. It's May 13th, 2022. This is Critical Thinking, Part One, mid-month. I figured I'll do it in the middle of the month from now. It's a little better. Well, we have a flurry of activities in the world, as apparent. Everyone should know. We jumped from a pandemic and lockdowns and masks and vaccinating and all these things to Russia, bad Russia, after we heard that for 4 years when Trump was in office. And then all of a sudden that kind of like faded away, and now we're on this abortion topic, which the Supreme Court did not reverse this decision. They handed it back to the states as it was since the 60s. So some states it's perfectly fine, some states it's illegal. These people, it's using it as a tool, because every election, like midterms are coming up, they do is they use gay rights, abortion, flag burning, taxes, nationalism, some terrorism, I don't know, something to polarize everyone and make everyone nuts, the border crisis. They do this every time for decades, and people are like sheeple. They just listen and they don't think outside critically, as we're supposed to do on this channel. So to get back, why was it okay for the United States and NATO and its EU partners from 1992 till 2022 to bomb Afghanistan, Iraq, twice Iraq, remember? Millions of civilians were killed indiscriminately. They won't tell you the numbers. No one will release it. Massive bombing campaigns with B-52, B-1Bs, things of that nature. Then they had, you know, these Scud missiles. And then drone attacks on individuals where we would target individuals, terrorists. Most were bad people and terrorists, I agree. But innocent people next to them were also taken out. It wasn't just the one guy. That's not even funny, actually. There was a few times when the whole family died or innocent people around them. So it's okay for us, the West, to do these things with impunity and claim it's democracy or freedom, but we just left Iraq and Afghanistan. How come you don't hear one peep about Iraq after all the wars there? Not even a mention anywhere. You hear about Vietnam, which is another topic of based on a fake lie, which came out in 2003. The whole war was based on a lie about the Gulf of Tonkin incident, where it was not, they were not being fired upon. It was an error. But they used that to start the whole war. So these things, the military-industrial complex existed after World War II when the War Profiteering Acts were changed from 3% maximum profit for war-related industries to unlimited and during the Vietnam era. That's why Vietnam went on for probably 10 years, and there was so much controversy. Sorry, I was sounding British. Controversy, Brooklyn, I don't know what you want to say, but what happened was it was profitable to stay in war for these, and Eisenhower warned us about this after World War II, which I trusted him and Truman. But so now we have unlimited profits. So we had the boogeyman, I'm going to call it a boogeyman, in essence was the Soviet Union, maybe Red China a little bit, not till later. And billions and trillions and quadrillions of dollars spent on the Cold War, building weapons we can never use against them, nuclear things that are just, I used to kind of work a little bit in that field, so I'm familiar with, that are absurd to even consider using. So now, the Soviet Union collapses in 92, right? After the boogeyman disappears, military industrial contract don't have a purpose, does it? But they have NATO sitting there too, and they need stuff. Because the boogeyman still might attack Europe or something. All right, so here's the deal. Soviet Union collapses in 92. Iraq war starts in 92, the first one. Is that a coincidence? And then we leave the people, Saddam Hussein and his people, in charge after 92 until 2003. And then we attack again. What does that sound like? And then Afghanistan somehow gets blended into this. It had nothing to do with 9/11. Yeah, there was a guy there a few times years ago, but he wasn't there on the other side of the planet. And so these military industrial contract had tons of work bombing for 20, 30 years from 92 to 22. Endless amounts of weapons funding, $750 billion every year to our weapons, our military budget in the United States. When Russia has 70, I think, a year, we have 750 plus now. For what reason? Russia, the Soviet Union was gone. And I found out that during the whole time of the Cold War, when Soviet Union was this big evil empire, right? Guess where Europe got close to half of all its gas and oil and energy? Guess who they bought it from? You got it, Soviet Union. So why would you buy stuff from your enemy? So this whole thing is a sham. So anyway, the military industrial complex kind of ran out of a purpose in 2022 because the Arab Muslim terrorist ISIS, ISIL wars are over. Remember them things we had for 20 years after 9/11? It just vanished, right? So now, let's reignite the old bad Russia thing and make Putin look like Stalin, blahzy blah. It's a very complicated situation over there. Not like the media says. Russia was born in Kiev Rus in the 7th to 8th century. The first Tsar was sworn in. That place was always part of Russia. Okay? Turkey had it. Ottoman Turkey took it, and then Russia took it back. The Mongols had it. Russia took it back. Come on. How are Europeans and Americans sitting on occupied stolen land in Canada and America tell Russians what to do after we bombed Iraq and Afghanistan, killing millions? And then we dropped in Vietnam is another one. How many people died there? Civilians? No one knows. They'll never tell you. And then we dropped two atomic bombs on Japan. But only Russia's bad, right? But throughout this whole thing, Russia bad, Russia bad, Russia bad. Gleefully, the EU and America and the West trades with communist China, which has millions of the slaves, as we said before. Millions. No one cares about Asian slaves. The first people that should speak up were African Americans and the Jews and other people that were subject to this type of persecution and slavery. The Muslims in Turkey have rose up and protested China. I think them in Turkey, because most of these people are from Turkestan, I believe, that were kidnapped and brought to China as slaves. They're Muslims. They don't look Chinese. They look kind of Arabic. But it's horrible what's going on. And they had the Olympics there twice. Folks, I don't know what to say. They have Olympics there twice. Okay. I remember back in 2014 when this first happened. I was like, wait a minute here. This why we have how is Olympics after Putin in 2008? They had it in Beijing, which is bad enough. And then again, so excuse me. So we go here and we see like hypocrisy based on it's all based on money and lobbyists. Now let's see if this president administration cancels the tariffs on China that were installed by the last administration. If so, I think it's self-evident and undeniable what is going on here. It's all about that. And I think the whole pandemic and a multitude of other things have been done to take the heat off evil CCP, PLA China. Okay, and there's films coming out of millions of people locked in cities right now. We don't know if this is true or not. But they have done this before, folks. They're doing what Uyghurs for decades. They killed close, I think it was Mao, was close to 60 to 100 million of his own people from starvation, from bizarre policies of agriculture that totally didn't work. We know what happened in Tiananmen Square in 89 when I was in college. We saw that people vomited. There was dead students smashed with tanks, like hamburger meat all over the square. Yet we trade with them like they're nice because it's profitable. Slavery is profitable. As long as they're on the other side of the world and in Asians, it seems like it's okay, doesn't it? All the big box stores, big tech, everyone's participating. I have the list. It's thousands of companies in the West and in Europe. BMW, Mercedes, Apple, IBM, Hewlett Packard, everybody. Everybody's over there using slaves. And these are in the slave factories, not just normal ones. Human Rights Watch and other places, people have spoke upon this. But what do they do? Nope, turn the attention to Russia or Israel. Boycott either one, which is ridiculous. Okay? Anyway, peace out. Have a good month.